This is a day that Andy, too, has been waiting for a long time.
Oh, that's right. Yep. Going to Salem, Massachusetts.
We are driving to Salem, Massachusetts. This is a bucket list item. And Andy's grabbing the penny.
That's right. We're not starting this trip without that.
Put your thumb in there, sweetheart. We're going to say a little prayer. We had a flat tire the last time we were driving.
A blowout
on the camper, yep. But the dogs are ready, and we're ready, and we're going to a place that Andy's been looking a long time forward to seeing.
That's right, I have.
Salem,
Hershey,
Massachusetts.
Hershey,
come here.
Hey, man!
Hershey and Maggie, come here.
Where's Hershey?
Come here, Hershey girl.
Give
me a kiss, give him a kiss. Oh, yeah, my baby. We're going bye-bye.
Are you guys ready? You guys all ready?
We're going bye-bye in the car, aren't we?
Are you all ready?
We are.
We're
going in the car bye-bye, aren't we? Miggio and Hershey.
So I guess we're all ready. So let's fly to Salem.
Oh, I got my broom.
Salem, Massachusetts is located 20 miles north of Boston. Salem was founded in 1626, making it one of the oldest cities in the United States. Salem is best known as the location of the witchcraft hysteria of 1692 and remains as one of the darkest episodes in U.S. history.
1692. Salem was a rigid Puritan community, and there was widespread belief in the supernatural. There was controversy between the residents of Salem Town and Salem Village over property rights and the appointment of a local minister.
The village residents were unhappy with the choice of Reverend Samuel Parris as minister. Prior to the witchcraft allegations, a group of young girls, including Parris's own daughter Betty, began having mysterious emotional episodes.
Since no medical explanation could be found to explain the symptoms, which included convulsions, screaming, and strange trance-like states, Satan was blamed.
The Puritans believed that Satan could attack a victim through an intermediary such as a witch.
The girls said they had visions of three local women who appeared to them as apparitions and tried to harm them. The cycle of accusations began as more townspeople came forward to say they had been personally harmed by a witch.
As neighbor accused neighbor, it is likely the accusations were just a ploy to seize another person's land or to settle a personal vendetta. As Andy Two flies on her broomstick to one of Salem's most treasured landmarks, I have to take the trolley.
Today, there is only one building standing which was directly affiliated with the Salem witch trials. It is called the Witch House. And in 1692, it was the home of Salem magistrate Jonathan Corwin. Many pre-trial examinations of the men and women accused of witchcraft were held at this location.
This sign states that the house was built circa 1642 and restored by the city in 1946. Let's go inside and experience what life was like in the 17th century.
Here, Corwin would conduct business or entertain guests. These papers are reproductions of the documents dealing with the witch trials.
As a result of the witchcraft hysteria, over 150 people were arrested from Salem and surrounding communities. 25 people would lose their lives. And contrary to the popular beliefs...
Tell me, what do you do with witches?
No, they did not burn witches. 19 of those accused were executed by hanging. One was pressed to death with stones.
Heard your contempt and give us the name of the man that accused Putnam. You will say it, Corey.
Speak, man. You cannot relent. What say you, Corey?
Wait.
Lay on.
You're commanded by the court.
Lay on!
The other five died in jail due to the horrible conditions. How about we take a break from the morbid and have Andy 2 swing around and meet me downtown? So we're going to go for a little walk and continue to tag along in Salem, Massachusetts. Okay. She had to have landed somewhere around here. Ah, there she is.
When in Salem, you know what you do.
What's
you
that?
You go see pirates.
You gotta go see pirates.
Oh my God, Jimmy, look at this guy. He's got a beard and he's got a patch just like you. Oh, honey, come home with me. You're my surprise. Isn't he great?
Yeah.
I gotta get you a hat and this will be you perfectly.
Well, I'm glad you met the pirate.
This isn't Captain Jack, but oh well.
And look at that hand.
Hello there, buddy.
Pleased to meet you. We got a knife like this.
Yes, we do.
So Jimmy goes from Captain Jack to Captain Fireman.
Salem Fire.
Salem Memorial Fire Headquarters.
These guys put the witches out.
When they burn them?
Yeah, when they burn them.
Hey, Andy, are you in there? Downtown Salem. What do you think, babe?
It's a pretty cool town. I'd like to spend about a week here.
It would be nice.
But I'm happy with what we got.
Let's continue our journey.
New me? Right here, this is a new me.
That's the new you?
There you go. My youthful days. When I was skinny.
Hey babe, which purse will you purchase?
I want this one, but the zipper's broken on it.
Oh no. That is Samantha Stevens.
Now you are now Darren.
What's that?
Now you're Darren. Oh. Okay.
Pretty cool, huh?
It is, isn't it?
Yeah. And if you get a chance to visit Salem, this is exactly the spot where you can find the bewitching Samantha Stevens in Townhouse Square. And coincidentally, kitty corner to Samantha Stevens, we found this apartment, which looks like it probably belonged to Uncle Arthur.
My good fellow, we find that we can both dip and wave.
Hey, you baddies. Welcome to Salem. Home of witches and maybe a few relatives. You never know until you do some background history. Just taking a break, walking around in this 95-degree heat.
And when you're in 95-degree heat in Salem, Massachusetts, there's only one place to go to get a refreshing beverage. Bunghole Liquors.
Hey, Jimmy, look, it's Captain America.
Across the street, you're looking at the oldest candy company in America. Yes, it's the Ye Old Pepper Company. What say you, Andy Two?
Do you realize the Ye Old Pepper Company was founded in 1806?
Funny. This candy don't look 212 years old.
Really, Jimmy?
I don't care who you are, that's funny right there.
As I once again take the trolley, Andy too will be leading the way for us to our final destination for this trip to Salem. Oh yes, Andy too says we're coming back for sure. But now, we're off to the most sacred land of all in this, the city of Salem.
This is a burying point, dated to 1637. It is the oldest burial grounds in Salem. Some of Salem's most prominent citizens are interred here, including Justice John Hathorne from the Witchcraft Trial Court. Adjacent to the burial ground is the Salem Witch Trials Memorial. I'll just leave my broomstick here while we walk the grounds.
The memorial was dedicated exactly 300 years later, in 1992, and consists of 20 granite benches supported by a stone wall. Each bench is engraved with the name of one of the 20 people who were executed. Each of their final words have been carved into the stone. And it includes, O Lord, help me. And I am wholly innocent of such wickedness. And God knows I am innocent. And I do plead not guilty. All the dying words of the innocent.
Bridget Bishop was the first to be executed on June 10th, 1692. An elderly woman named Rebecca Nurse plus four others were executed on July 19th, 1692.
John Proctor and four others followed on August 19th, 1692. And as we highlighted earlier in the vlog, Giles Corey was pressed to death with stones on September 19th, 1692.
September 22nd, 1692 proved to be the most deadly day of all. Eight were executed, including Giles Corey's wife, Martha. Thanks to the memorial for the victims of the Salem Witch Trials of 1692, they will always be remembered. May they rest in peace.
Back on the trolley again, and we're getting set to head on to our next adventure. But you're looking at Nathaniel Hawthorne's house right there, and the next time we come to Salem, we're going to delve into more of those type of things, the famous houses, including the House of Seven Gables. But for now, on a side note, the following year, in the spring of 1693, the newly formed Topps Trading Card Company released its inaugural set of cards known as the 1692 Season's Top Swingers.
No, they didn't.
What? Too soon? Hey, wait a minute. It's a joke. Come on, this vlog was way too serious. We needed to add some humor at the end. Come back! Well, I guess she's on to our next destination on her own, and I gotta catch up to her. Thanks for joining us, and if you're new to the vlog, please make sure that you hit that subscribe button. And we'll see you next time, because this vlog is history.